In a recent interview, 50 Cent said on the Breakfast Club that you guys didn't beat the feds because you wasn't involved. Like, hearing that comment, how do you feel about it?
He said we didn't beat the feds?
Yeah, he said that basically you didn't beat the feds because you wasn't involved in anything.
Well, you know, I can't talk to a federal agent. He trying to get someone to incriminate themselves or say something. And again, I don't buy into all of the gossip, nigga. So niggas could talk whatever he said, you know, cool, that's his opinion. Or, you know, he's trying to cooperate. Like, I got statements and paperwork with Curtis Jackson, but no one want to believe it because they think Curtis Jackson is some rough, tough nigga. I never seen that side of that nigga. You know what I'm saying? I don't know him, but when I did come across him, I did put my hands on him. We did have confrontation, and I didn't get the short end of the stick. If you understand, I seen that man run from fucking Ja Rule. I seen it, but no one want to believe it because it's like you said, it's 50 Cent. He this tough nigga. But I tell everyone, you don't got to ask me. You could just look at history to know exactly what a person is. I don't need to do it, and I don't want to do it. I wish that man all the best. You heard me?
No,
all
no
of that
doubt.
Shit is 20 plus no, no years doubt. Older. I don't have a beef with a nigga I don't know. I don't do that. That's that sucker shit. I'm not that nigga. So he could talk all he want. Irv didn't know him. Ja didn't know him. How could we have a real beef with him? It turned serious because we really paid a lot of lawsuits. We did have order protections against us, so we couldn't come within 1,000 feet of this nigga. You know what I'm saying? But this is what he don't want people to know because he made those moves. But it's all good. I'm not even the nigga to talk about it. I don't care. You feel me? And whatever he said, I don't give a fuck. That's his opinion. He got a right to say whatever he want. But it sounds like he getting a nigga to, he want niggas to react and say something stupid. Did you hear what he said? Say it again. And you tell me I'm wrong. See, I'm a real hood nigga. I'm really active out there with real people. So at the end of the day, it sound like he looking. What's the name of this podcast?
Death of the Clout Chaser.
Okay, well, kill that nigga already then. Because that's all he is. That's what made his whole career. And he still do it. See, when you in life, in business, and you make money from or become successful from doing something, whatever it is, you're going to do that your whole life because you know how to do it. He knows how to do that. He's very good at it. You understand? I respect that. He's very good at it. It's all good. But what he said, okay, I'm going to ask you some. If you real about what you were, what he said, he's looking for a nigga to react. Like, what? We wasn't part of that. Yes, we were. To increase. You understand? He's trying to take away something that, fuck out of here, nigga. You can't take away my history and my credibility by your fucking clout chasing ass shit. I'm not cool with, that's not cool. But you know, there's a lot of suckers out here that might think, oh, he right, cool, good for them. Good luck, God bless. I wish all black men and black women the best. You hear me? I ain't got nothing against nobody.
He also said that he thinks that Prem should have been behind him and Ja Rule at the same time. You think that was a good idea?
Listen to me, Prem was managing 50 Cent. Again, public don't act like they know that. So you tell me, put it in perspective. I try to do this so people understand the lies that this man spit out his mouth, that niggas swallow and eat it and believe it. You know, it's good for gossip. It ain't good on real shit. It's not real. So it can never move me. See, I'm not my brother and I'm not Ja. I don't react the way they do to shit. And I would tell them, like, nigga, the fuck, it's not even real. How could Preem, my OG, okay, manage somebody and I got beef with him? You tell me how that make any sense. My other OG had managed him right after. Black Hand, Chaz, God bless the dead, managed him and we got beef with him. You tell me. We tried to have meetings 3 times. He don't talk that. That niggas never showed up because he thought niggas was gonna hurt him. So he would never show up. 3, you strike out. That's when he was like, don't ask for no more meetings. I'll give you some more facts. Go search it. Niggas want to talk this clout chasing shit or whatever. Go add. The nigga bought 4 beats for my brother. Or he never got to get them. But if you don't fuck with niggas, why are you buying beats to make your album? We charged him. We gave Tina Davis, who is the running his project for him when he was at Columbia Records. We gave her a price at $200,000 for 4 tracks, which was love at the time. So they sent the $100,000. We never did no work, but he, out of his budget. But why would he do that if he don't fuck with niggas? He just wanted to be down with Murder, Inc. He's a Queens nigga, knew we was about that life, everything. And that's it. And we with Preem, the king of Southside. He's from Rochdale, nigga. Like, people don't understand the truth. He Rochdale's next to Southside. He was living in his grandmama's house in Rochdale.
I got you.
But it's all good. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, good luck, God bless, my nigga. But I'm not in that all of that fake world shit.